Can we get everybody to take their places, please?
And
action.
Oh, I'm home. Thank the good Lord, I'm home.
Hey, what does it take to get a waitress around this
place? Describing Barn Bar is a very difficult thing. It's like Twin Peaks meets Monty Python meets Cheers.
You mean a full-blown psychotic episode?
It could happen.
Mm. Ooh, that'd be a nice break in the day, wouldn't it?
Ooga, ooga, but Nietzsche.
It's kind of like a cross between Cheers and Deliverance.
Nietzsche, Nietzsche.
Leichenfreud.
It's a combination of Cheers, Prairie Home Companion, and Twin Peaks.
It's almost like being at a bar and collaborating with your friends.
Would you like a little vodka?
The atmosphere is almost like a party, but with a purpose.
Yeah, let's just blunder our way through this.
It's kind of like that old Mickey Rooney, Judy Garland premise, like, hey kids, let's put on a show. We can use Bob's Barn. It's like, we've actually done that as adults. That's pretty amazing.
That's still $10, dude.
Bob! While you're gone, can I be in charge of the bar?
No. Oh my God, no.
I'll take care of that situation as soon as I figure out who I am.
That's really tacky.
Yeah, I weren't tacky enough, apparently.
He definitely has some explaining to do.
Yeah, don't we all?
Well, he said that he's got this crazy idea to have people come out to his barn, that he's made a set, and that we could come up with our own characters and kind of improv and build a theater show that we would put on the internet.
You could act surprised and get up. Joey could give you a mean look. I don't know, but
I think there is a strong flavor of what it is like to live in Minnesota. A lot of it's stereotypical, but it's true. I mean, the goofy accents that we play up.
What in the name of Hacksaw Jim Duggan are you hollering about?
The fact that, you know, it's cold and there's nothing to do and we're in a small town, so everybody's in a bar and just drinking. I mean, I grew up in a small town clear across the country, and that's the same thing there. So it's kind of a common theme that a lot of people can relate to.
What would you say the Cubs have been doing to me for the last 27 years?
Yeah, and they didn't even buy you dinner.
Yeah, or have a cigarette afterwards.
They're really just a weird, wacky bunch of misfits in this very fictional small town.
He's been getting in touch with his inner smelt.
Oh boy, that's frightening.
I get a lot of things like, is that you in that Barn Bar thing?
Sliding home to the promised land.
Yeah, that's me. I'm proud to say it's me in that Barn Bar thing.
My name is Bob Sanborn, and I am the originator of the show Barn Bar. It takes place here in my barn, and I play the character of Nervous Bob, who is the bartender. A good friend of mine who has a theater company down in Chicago has complimented me a few times with the comment that he still hasn't understood anything that's happened, but he loves it.
You kidnapped Slider? Yeah!
Awesome! Can we eat it? I'm hungry.
I'm gonna pull your sticky mouth!
We're going into season 4, so we have completed 3 seasons. I get all my ideas at 3 o'clock in the morning. I wake up and I have ideas, and I write them down.
The guy that's with him will kind of peel off and head over that direction.
The idea for this came to me in its entirety, you know, waking up from some dream.
I would say probably through here.
So the next logical thing seemed to be to put it on YouTube.
My name is Chris Atwood. My character's name is Brian Wilcox. The beauty of it was there was no set rehearsal. There wasn't, you know, 6 weeks or 12 weeks out of my life where I was gonna be here 5 nights a week away from my family or work. So every 2 weeks we'd get together out here and basically just goof off.
Strange guy. Deeply troubled.
My name is Debbie Neville. My character is DL. I love Barn Bar because it's unique, it's unusual. I've done a lot of theater, and a lot of people don't want to have the obligation of rehearsals and memorization and so forth. So that was appealing to me.
Come on, yeah. I need details.
My name is Lisa Lewis Grill. I play a character called Patty Wormwood. Look at this place. How could you not want to come here? What a great thing to do. You can produce a show, you can fulfill your artistic needs, but you can sit and be with this wonderful group of creative people. They're funny. They're kind. They're energetic. And I can't think of a better thing to do with my Thursday night.
Get ready. Go.
Turn off the ignition.
We've evolved quite a bit over the years with that whole process of how the show is produced and how it comes into being.
Two begins here.
At this stage, what we're doing now is that we will write a script in advance. So the actors and technicians will have a chance to look the script over in advance. And then I'll schedule a night or two for everyone to come out and do the taping.
We'll go through this probably two or three times as a wide shot.
And then it'll go into the hands of the film editor.
The episodes are only about 5 to 7 minutes long. And we shoot an episode in a night.
Quiet, please. Action.
He's got some lighting set up out there, and then I'll bring a camera and stuff and set up.
Duct tape fixes everything, right?
Yes, it does.
And shoot whatever we can in a limited period of time, and we go boom, 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 boom.
Action, action, action.
Bob.
Wake up.
And when it's done, then I go try to make something out of whatever I got.
I like it because I don't keep a journal and I don't take enough pictures of my life. But I can go back and watch season one, which is from 3 years ago, and go, oh my gosh, I remember that weekend that we're out here and then how much fun that was. And to think how nervous I was the first time I came out here, because I didn't know Bob that well, didn't know some of the fellow actors and actresses that I'd be working with. And now I go, oh, now these are my pals that are, you know, my friends that if I see in the grocery store, I'm running up and giving them a hug because we built a relationship through working together.
I love the experience. I wouldn't trade it for anything, and I would always want to do it no matter what the end product.
Andy, come on, man.
Oh, we got it.
Because the most important thing about doing the show is that everyone should leave here having had a really good time.
And that's where you come in.
Some people go, well, nobody watches that show, or I can't even get my wife to watch, you know, an episode, and I've gotten over that over the years because I don't really care. It doesn't matter who else watches them and how they look when they're finished. It's that I had fun making the shows with my friends.
One on one isn't always two in the Barn Bar. Sometimes it's like 4.5. It's one of those things that you just never know what's gonna happen. And that's what's wonderful about the performance. You just don't know. So when you're watching it, you don't know what's going to happen next. And we don't either when we're in it. Just come in and see what happens.
Hey, who wants another drink?
Oh,
I do!